Well, you are in between two things. You can enjoin right and you can forbid wrong. If you cannot enjoin right, at least you can forbid wrong. You can lessen the harm that may befall the whole of society. Other people may not mean it. Other people may be doing things out of their good hearts. Just like these people wanted to drill a hole because they didn't want to bother the other people. So participation, brothers and sisters, is mandatory. It's obligatory. It is part of the mission of the Muslim to be observant of what's going on in his society, in her society, and trying to do good deeds and benefit everybody, not just looking for his or her own interest. So this is inshallah, I hope that we learned the lesson from this, that you know, there are so many different troubles around us. There are so many different problems in terms of the society, in terms of the laws. We should be, as Muslims, standing up for justice. We should be fighting poverty. We should be fighting crime. We should be concerned in terms of the education. What kind of education are people getting? We should be involved in the schools. We should be involved in local politics. We should be involved in provincial politics, in federal politics, in all levels of the decision-making process, because all of them affect us and affect others. And as Muslims, we cannot sit down and be on the margin of society. This is absolutely unacceptable. If individuals wanted to do that because they are unable to be engaged in society, we may say, okay, as individuals, you may be able to do so. But as a society, as a community, it is haram to be on the margin of society, brothers and sisters. And that's why voting, which is a right and responsibility in Canada for every citizen, we say it's also, from the Sharia point of view, it is responsibility upon every Muslim to be participating in the decision-making process. Again, at least if you cannot, you know, enjoin right, you can lessen the wrongs. A lot of times you have two things, one is worse than the other. Okay, you choose one that is a little bit better than the worst one. So this is another one. Number three, in our deen, there is no rahbaniyah. And rahbaniyah is monasticism. Rahbaniyah means that you isolate yourself, you sit, I'm devoting my life, I will sit and be in the mosque all the time. This happened with other nations. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala tells us that, like the Christians, they invented rahbaniyah, and they did not live up to the standards of that. Allah did not order them to do it, but they wanted this for themselves, yet they did not live up to the standard. What is the rahbaniyah of this ummah? What is very important in this ummah in terms of participation? The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam says in the hadith, عن أنس بن مالك أن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم قال لكل نبي رهبانية ورهبانية هذه الأمة الجهاد في سبيل الله عز وجل. Every ummah has rahbaniyah, certain kind of idea, basic idea. The rahbaniyah of this ummah is that you make jihad for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So for somebody to say, I do not concern myself with all, you know, the corruption, all the facade, all the fitna in this society, he said, brother, you're not approaching this the right approach. The Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was praying in Al-Kaaba, in Mecca. When he was in Mecca, there was 360 idols inside the Kaaba, and the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was praying there. He didn't say, these people are worshipping, I should not be engaged with them. We had a message to deliver. And this one, al-jihad fi sabilillah, I hope that we understand the jihad and the general meaning of it when we exert an effort to implement the rules of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in our daily lives. That's what's very important. And I just referred to you the verse in Surah Al-Hajj, the last verse of Surah Al-Hajj. وَجَاهِدُوا فِي اللَّهِ حَقَّ جِهَادِهِ وَاجْتَبَاكُمْ وَمَا جَعَلَ عَلَيْكُمْ فِي الدِّينِ مِنْ حَرَجٍ مِلَّةَ أَبِيكُمْ إِبْرَاهِيمَ هُوَ سَمَّاكُمُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ مِنْ قَبْلُ وَفِي هَذَا لِيَكُونَ الرَّسُولُ شَهِيدًا عَلَيْكُمْ وَتَكُونُوا شُهَدَاءَ عَلَى النَّاسِ فَأَقِيمُوا الصَّلَاةَ وَآتُوا الزَّكَاةَ وَاعْتَصِمُوا بِاللَّهِ هُوَ مَوْلَاكُمْ فَنِعْمَ الْمَوْلَى وَنِعْمَ النَّصِيرُ. You should do jihad in Allah, fi sabilillah, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, haqqa jihad, the true jihad, the true jihad. He had chosen you, and he did not want to burden you with anything in your deen. It is the deen of your father, millat abikum, your father Ibrahim. He named you Muslims. This could be Allah named you Muslims, and it could be that Ibrahim alayhi salam. But most likely it's Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala named us Muslims before. وَفِي هَذَا, and in this, that the messenger is a witness upon you, and you are witnesses upon people. How can you be a witness upon people if you are not participating? You cannot do that. You need, again, I go to the idea of building a model that is complete model. And so it is our responsibility again, brothers and sisters, that inshallah we participate in the decision-making process. Alhamdulillah, this is our right in this society that we vote. So I urge everybody, there are some elections that are coming up soon. We need our own maybe candidates. If we do not have them, there are other candidates. Some of them are better than the others. But you cannot sit on the side and say, let people decide, I am not interested. Or to say, my vote doesn't count. Your vote does count. Your vote is very important. And when we come out and tell the people, we tell the politicians that we have 60,000, 70,000 people here of Muslims who can do something, they will be running to us and asking us, how can we help you? What can we do for you? Of course, I am not looking narrowly at our own benefits, brothers and sisters. I hope that we get engaged for the benefit of everybody in this society, as Islam is rahma lil alameen, wa ma arsalnaka illa rahmatan lil alameen. We are not seeking just special things for us as Muslims. We shouldn't be looking for that. We can, inshallah, achieve good things for ourselves, but our interest is for the whole society. We want the whole ship of society to be saved. We want the whole ship of society to be saved. And we cannot do that unless we are participating, unless we are doing something, inshallah ta'ala. And remember, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, وَاتَّقُوا فِتْنَةً لَا تُصِيبَنَّ الَّذِينَ ظَلَمُوا مِنْكُمْ خَاصَّةً وَعَلَمُوا أَنَّ اللَّهَ شَدِيدُ الْعِقَابِ. That you should fear fitna, and fitna could be a test, could be trial, could be tribulation, could be many different things. That it is not going to be particular to any people, but it will befall everybody. So it is our responsibility to be out there, inshallah, trying to prevent fitna, trying to prevent bad things from happening. And so again, we save the society, we save ourselves, and we are shuhada, we are witnesses upon people. We carry the message of the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam, who was the last messenger, and there are no more messengers. And thus every Muslim is an envoy, every Muslim is an ambassador, every Muslim is a messenger with a small m. Every Muslim is a messenger for the message of Islam, to let people know about the beauty of this deen. And again, inshallah ta'ala, everybody will benefit.